morning, everybody. Frank Valkyrie here. Today we're doing a tribute reaction. Unfortunately, another great artist passed away, Meat Loaf. And like I said also in the video before, it's never something that you kind of consciously think every day about those artists. I mean, most of the time you feel comfortable in knowing that they're there, even if you don't check their music all the time. But the fact that they're still around, you know, gives you a sense of comfort, a sense of reference. I think it's like this for many, many people. Because those artists, they become part of our lives. Their music become part of our lives. Memories are attached to it. Everybody their own in their specific time of growth, whatever. So, and of course, I'm no exception, like I said also in the other video. This particular song, of course, for me, it's relegated in a way to a specific time of my life in the mid-90s, where we went always in this pub owned by somebody that then became a friend. And the pub was called South Compass. And this guy was the only one having like this satellite dish, huge thing that he could turn around. And I don't know what other machinery he had, but he could get like all kinds of channels, which we couldn't see on normal Italian TV, of course. You know, we just had the normal TV, you know, and that was it. Whatever they were running. And he had all those British channels, all those other channels, American channels. And he always had on, you know, in his place, in this room was a sort of ballroom, like 5 to 6, I don't know, not so big, but with a projector on the wall, and he would just project this TV channel, music channel. I don't know if it was the American MTV or some other channel, I don't remember, honestly. But he also ran a playlist that he had, and I remember this song always playing a certain time in the night. And of course, we have so many beautiful memories attached in that place, in that pub, you know, when I was like 19, 18, 20. So, yeah. Wow. It's always strange. It's always strange to you come of age and you start to see things closer and further, you know, in your life, in terms of relationship ending, you know, for the obvious reason. Anyway, let's pay tribute to Meat Loaf, a legendary singer that has sold more than 100 million album worldwide, still one of the best rock singer ever. Let's go. I apologize in advance if I have to blur the video, cut it, but those classic, usually they always get blocked, always, at least here in the Netherlands. I love it. And I would do anything for love. I'd run right into hell and back. Wow. I would do anything for love. I'll never lie to you, and that's a fact. Well, just that intro with the piano then slows down and then immediately starts with the basically a chorus, you know, so to speak. Wow, what a classic. And also you see the like, I always had the feeling that here, because he was so huge, you know, I guess thanks to the success of the 70s also, he wanted to redo a little bit the theme of Beth Out of Hell. And also, like, you know, always the bike, of course, it's part of the allure of the iconic album cover, you know, like the bike shooting out of a tomb, out of hell. So I had the feeling that sort of here we have kind of condensation of those elements that at the time in the early 90s, of course, with the better equipment or whatever available, he wanted to do, you know, a better video. And he condensed this sort of new iteration of what he was famous for. But I'll never forget And here we go, the recurring joke. I won't do that, but I won't do that. That could mean so many things. I tell you later what I think. And some days it don't come easy, and some days it don't come hard. Some days it don't come at all, and these are the days that never end. And some nights you're breathing fire, and some nights you're caught in ice. Some nights you're like nothing I've ever seen before. Will again. And maybe I'm crazy, oh it's crazy and it's true. I know you can save me, no one else can save me now. But you, as long as the planets are turning, as long as the stars are burning, as long as your dreams are coming, you better believe it, that I would do anything for love. And I love the look of this. Of course, so many rock and roll bands were having this type of look, including Guns N' Roses in November Rain. And I don't know who came first for this video. Probably this came after. I don't know. I'm not 100% sure. But for sure, Guns N' Roses actually took inspiration also in terms of music from Meatloaf, for sure, in terms of ballads. I mean, this guy has been doing this since the 70s. So, 70s. So. And I'll be there till the final act. And I would do anything for love. And I'll take the vow and seal up. Beauty and the Beast. But I'll never forgive myself if we don't go all the way. Sorry. Tonight, and I would do anything for love, but I won't do that. No, I won't do that. I would do anything. Man, so energetic. This is such a great ballad. This is like, in a way, like, I understand if people like, oh, it's kind of, you know, there is some kind of cheese in it. For me, totally fine. It's a great composition, great arrangement with this beautiful, powerful voice of Meatloaf. It's just a classic. It's actually a masterpiece of rock ballads, you know. To me, this is as good as, I want to say, like, you have those songs which are in the same ballpark. I'm not comparing them, but if you have to put some greatest 100, you know, ballads of all time, you know, you gotta put Bohemian Rhapsody very close to the top, or at the top, whatever, depending also on subjective taste. You gotta put this song in there too. I don't care if it's in number 20 or 30 or 50, it's in there. It's in there 100%. I'm just recovering from this stupid COVID thing, and I'm fine. I'm just have some cough left from the past actually 10 days. I had just 4 days which I had fever, and then a sore throat, and then it passed. But this thing, it's a little bit lingering a little bit, the coughing. So, but for the rest, I'm all right. So when I read that he passed away because of that, I was really upset, you know, really, really upset. Really, really upset. I don't want to get into the details of personal choices, you know, but sometimes I'm like, come on, come on, you know. And some days I pray for silence. I could be still here. Some days I pray for soul. Some days I just pray to the god of sex and drums. 74 is young, right? I also, lady, I don't know, you, but you just enter a house that you don't know, right? There are candles, fine. It's a kind of cozy gothic look. Maybe that's what you like. So it's a dream come true for you, but at the same time, you just go and take a bath in that house? I mean, hey, lady. Eh? Lady. Eh?
As long as the wheels are turning, as long as the fires are burning, as long as your dreams are coming true, you better believe it.
And I will do anything for love.
And you know it's true, and that's a fact.
That's true, that's a fact. This also, of course, this also reminds me, probably was inspired by the Bram Stoker Francis Ford Coppola Dracula movie with Keanu Reeves. What's also the other, Winona Ryder? Anthony Hopkins. And of course, Dracula. Rest him.
So long, I would do.
I was thinking, like, luckily the guy is still with us. All of a sudden, you know, I confused the actor that did Snape in the Harry Potter saga with the guy that did Dracula, of course. Which, yeah, totally different person.
No, 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 I won't do.
For a guy that didn't like to see himself in a mirror, he had a lot of mirror in that house, eh? Oh my god, that's so fucking great. Oh man, the cheese is there. The cheese is there, but it's fine. We love cheese here, okay? It's great. And a nice French baguette. And again, like, of course, great performance. The female singer here, there, just iconic as well. And I love the fact that she's telling him, you know, like the stuff that he's supposed to do. And he goes like, I can do that. So it's kind of funny if you say it that way, like, I want you to do this, this and that. I can do that. So in a way, we also know, you know, like she's telling him the stuff that she wants to be done. So yeah, we don't need to know, but I won't do that because she's not telling you. She's just telling you what she wants. He doesn't want to move on. It's very simple. Doesn't want to move on from the memory, from the hurt. She's telling him, like, it's time. Let go of the spell. Let go. Let go. And he's so, like, enamored with that pain. And that's probably the meaning behind it all. Let go of the pain that sometimes remains the only thing that you have to remember and you don't want to let go. Let go.
I won't do that.
I know the terror.
I mean, honest to God, if you know, like a lady like this showed up in my house with this voice and her beauty, I mean, I don't know what I would be going through. I will forget very easily. Very easily, I will forget. I will go, let's go. Yes, right now, forever. I don't have a bike. We walk. Doesn't matter.
No, I won't do anything for
he won't be screwing around, huh? He won't be screwing around because he loves her.
I would do anything for love. I would do anything for love. But I won't do that. No, I won't do
Wow, what a freaking masterpiece of rock ballad this song is. My God, man, I just wish, God damn it, I wish you were just here. Yeah, it's sad. It's always sad, really. Sometimes I'm like, as an artist, as a human being in general, I'm not prepared, like many of you. Like, no, but none of us is prepared, you know? Neither for the people further or closer in our life to see them go. We're not prepared. We just deal with it. You never get ready. And sometimes you just wish, okay, let's hold on the illusion a little longer, you know? You know it happens, but in the case of Meatloaf again, 74 is, it's kind of young. It's kind of, yeah, you could go easy. You could go easy nowadays. For another 10, 15 year run, easy, you know? So, yeah, that's really, truly, truly a pity. Anyway, rest in peace, guys. I'll talk to you later. Ciao.